My respects to you.
There was a corpse in the grave, but no ring. What the fuck is going on?
Easy, Hal. Hold your horses. If the ring wasn't on the corpse, the executioner must have taken it before he buried the body.
I can see where this is going. You want me to get the ring from the executioner?
Clever lad. Only I wouldn't recommend talking to him about it. He's a bit touchy on the subject of robbing the dead. It'd be better to pinch it from his house.
All right, I'll go and find that ring.
It should be in a trunk somewhere in the house. And look here, Henry. Do you know how to get past a lock?
Get past a lock? You mean jemmy it off with a crowbar?
No, you don't. I mean the delicate, gentle art of opening it quietly and with sensitivity, like popping a young maiden's cherry.
Yeah, I haven't had a chance to try that yet.
Fucking hell. How did I get landed with a cretin like you? I'll have to teach you then. Come with me. Hold the lockpick in your right hand and use it to feel out the tumbler. In your left hand, you hold the blade and use it to turn the whole mechanism back and right. It's quite easy. It only takes a bit of practice. Now try poking around in the lock with the pick until you feel the right point where the tumbler is. Got it? Good. Now turn the whole lock with the blade, but don't stop holding the tumbler with the pick. Otherwise, you'll be fucked and you'll have to start. You forced it and broke the lock pick. That crack could be heard in Kuttenberg. You have to watch out for that. An experienced guard will recognize the sound at once. You're a dab hand, Hal. Make something out of you yet. But remember, this trunk's only for practice. With real locks, you have to watch out for the pick. Try it a few more times if you like. Nate, good luck.
Thank you.
What? This is nothing but an ordinary copper band. It's not worth a tin penny. I have that ring for you.
Good. Nice to know you're the sort of lad I can trust with a job like that. Now run with the ring to Wojtek, the miller in Kohelnitz. He'll have some work for you, and I'll have something for you soon, too. A clever fellow like you will never want for work. At the very least, I'll buy risky goods from you. I mean, the kind that used to belong to someone else and you can't sell to just anyone.
Stolen goods? Thanks, but no thanks. I'm not a thief. Can you tell me...
Do you know anything about those Cumans?
The heathen scum that Sigismund brought here. Why do you even ask? You've seen with your own two eyes what they're capable of.
That's all. Tell me something about yourself.
There's nothing much to tell. I was born at the mill, I live here, and I'll surely die here. But before I do, I've plenty of work to do, and I hope I live to see peace in this land again.
What are you up to? How would you like to, I don't know, come for a walk?
A walk? I'd like that very much, but I can't right now, Hal. Give me some time to settle in, will you?
If that's what you want.
It's not you, Hal. It's just this isn't a good time.
Trying to flog me stolen goods, eh? I see what you're up to. You won't get much from me for that. How much do you have in mind? See now? I knew we'd come to an agreement.
God be with you.
I'm here for training.
Yes, hear that voice Sir Radzik sent?
Yes, that's me.